Yes, ladies and gentlemen, welcome back to DFS Fridays, plays and fades video. So before we get into week three, let's touch on how we did last week in week two. Actually, let's move on. Let's forget about week two. We're on to week three now. We'll start off with the quarterback that I love this week, and that's Cam Newton. I'm nicknaming the New Orleans Saints the Jumpstart. And any offense that is struggling this year, when you have the Saints on your schedule, it's going to jumpstart your offense. The matchup is so good. Don't overthink it. Don't worry about popularity. Play Cam this week. Next up is the guy that I am absolutely in love with this week, and that is Le'Veon Bell. Here's the thing about Le'Veon. This is the lowest salary we're gonna see on him all year, 8,700 on FanDuel. And this is probably gonna be the lowest ownership on Le'Veon Bell also. The reason why he's gonna be so low owned, he's just burned everybody the first 2 weeks. In a game where Pittsburgh should be up, if I'm gonna pay up for a guy this week, it's gonna be Le'Veon Bell. Next up, we're gonna move over to wide receiver. And once again, I'm gonna give you two wide receivers because I love both of them that much. Keenan Allen and AJ Green. So we'll start off with Keenan Allen. So far this year, Keenan Allen has played 63% of his snaps in the slot. And who's the slot corner for the Kansas City Chiefs? Phillip Gaines. According to Pro Football Focus, out of the 119 cornerbacks last year that were eligible, Phillip Gaines was ranked 117.
Sorry.
Bless you, Joe. Keenan Allen, since 2015, has had 10 games of 10 or more targets. Nobody else on his team has had 5. Don't worry about Marcus Peters. Keenan Allen has owned them in the past. Next up, another guy who I'm hoping breaks out because he was my first round pick in fantasy. Thanks a lot, AJ Green, for the two back-to-back shitty performances, but I love it this week. Cincinnati Bengals are projected to be trailing this game, according to Vegas, because they are a 9-point underdog on the road in Green Bay. The Bengals just fired their offensive coordinator, deleted him out of the picture. What happens when the offensive coordinator gets fired? The new guy comes in and he feeds the ball to his best players. Nobody is as talented as AJ Green on the Cincinnati offense. For a guy that has 25-point upside, this is an absolute smash spot. Next up, we're going with my favorite tight end this week, Jake the Snake Doyle. Last time I had Doyle up here, you guys made a reference to the defense special teams. Blame the guy behind the camera, Joe, for that mistake. Thank you very much.
You're welcome.
Jake Doyle last week had 8 targets, 8 catches. Seems like Jacoby Brissett has found who his guy is on that offense, and it's Jake the Snake, baby. Play him. Dirt cheap on FanDuel. Must play this week at tight end. Next up is the defense I like this week. And if you know anything about me, you know I'm a big Giant fan. And this is going to hurt when I do this. I love me the Philadelphia Eagles. But let's be honest. The Giants offense is pathetic right now. The offensive line can't block anybody. And the Eagles have one of the best defensive lines in football. I'm praying for you, Eli, this week for you to make it out alive out of Philadelphia. A place of horrors for the Giants offense in the past couple years. Eagles are priced at 4,500 on FanDuel. And I think they are in a very great spot. So this is the play section for this week. Let's move on over to the fades. And we're going to start off with Russell Wilson at quarterback. Russell Wilson and the Seattle Seahawks are going on the road to Tennessee this week. Seattle offensive line has not been any better than the Giants this year. It's Russell Wilson's ability to move around in the pocket that buys him time and makes that offensive line not look as bad. Until proven otherwise, I'm fading a lot of people on the Seattle offense. Russell Wilson is 7,800 on FanDuel. Pay up another $100 to get Matthew Stafford in your lineup. That's what I would recommend. Next up is the running back that I'm fading this week, and that's simply based off the price. LeSean McCoy. We saw what happened last week. We talked up Ezekiel Elliott. He laid an egg. McCoy is playing that same defense at home though, so maybe a little silver lining there. But here's the thing about McCoy. McCoy is priced at 8,200 on FanDuel. Jay Ajayi is also priced at 8,200 and Devontae Freeman. I'd much rather go to those two guys than LeSean McCoy. Next up, the wide receiver position. The wide receiver that we're fading this week, DeAndre Hopkins. I know what you're thinking. The Texans are a 14-point underdog going into New England this week. But if we know anything about the Patriot defense, the Patriot way, they eliminate your best receiver. DeAndre Hopkins is priced around the AJ Green, Keenan Allen, and Brandon Cooks area. Much rather go to those guys than DeAndre Hopkins. I don't really have a tight end that I'm going to fade this week, so I'm going to give you another wide receiver that I'm going to fade. And this is simply because I think he might be utilized as a decoy this week. Jordy, ouch, my hamstring. I cost the lamb a lot of money last week, Nelson. Featured in the play section last week for week two, he did not put up not a single point. Thank you. I think Jordy Nelson is going to have a similar role to what Odell Beckham Jr. had on Monday Night Football. He's just going to be a decoy out there. I'd much rather go to Devontae Adams if I'm targeting anyone from the Packers. Last but not least, the defense that I'm fading this week, The Minnesota Vikings. If you guys listen to the podcast, you know that I've made a investment in the Tampa Bay Buccaneers, so I've kept a close eye on this team. I think that their offense is severely slept on, and their team is severely slept on. Minnesota's defense might be in a tough spot because they might be on the field so much. Sam Bradford is still questionable, leaning towards doubtful for this week's game. I'm just so sold on the Eagles this week, unfortunately, that I'd much rather go there. So there you have it, week 3 edition of the Plays and Fades. I'm the Lamb. You can find me at LambVM10 on Twitter, Snapchat, and Instagram. If you want to hear more about DFS, I have a podcast called Degeneration Bets. The link is in the bio below. That is all, and see you next week.